In the previous discussion, I was talking about the orthogonal trajectory as the application of differential equation. We solved certain problems to find out orthogonal trajectory by forming a differential equation, and then differential of orthogonal trajectory concept application was there. And later we were able to solve the differential equation, and then we obtained the new family of curves which act as orthogonal trajectory to the given curve. Now, the problem which was discussed under discussion in the previous lecture was to prove that confocal conics system of confocal conics x square divided by a square plus lambda plus y square divided by b square plus lambda is equal to 1. Already few steps we had written there by eliminating this parameter lambda, where lambda was the parameter. To prove that confocal conics is self orthogonal, what we do here, what we learn from this concept, self orthogonal means after eliminating the parameter alpha to form a differential equation, and then we apply the concept of orthogonal trajectory, that is replacing the derivative dy by dx by minus of dx by dy, and if the equation at that stage remains to be same, the differential equation at that stage remains to be same, then we say that because even if you solve, you will get back the same type of original solution, that is as it is given as x square by this much and plus y square by this much is equal to 1. At that stage we were able to tell they are self orthogonal to each other, and the differential equation which we were solving during that elimination process of the parameter lambda, and we had this equation, that is x square plus x into y y dash minus y x minus y square y dash is equal to a square minus b square. This was the equation we got after elimination of this and forming a differential equation, that is elimination of lambda, that is the parameter. Now for this we apply, at up to here it is a formation of differential equation to the given family of curves. This family of curves is nothing but f of x comma y and lambda, that is equal to 0, where lambda was the parameter, including two arbitrary constants a and b. Then lambda we eliminated in this equation, lambda is not there. This is called a differential equation. Now we apply the concept of differential of orthogonal trajectory by differential of orthogonal trajectory we have to replace dy by dx, that is by minus of it is dx by dy, wherever y dash is there, that is dy by dx, and it is to be replaced by minus dx by dy, and next part is to solve that differential equation. From this type of differential equation, it will be changing into another form. Then let us do that. Then x square plus x into y minus it is dx by dy, that is y dash minus yx minus y square, it is minus dx by it is dy equal to a square minus b square. Then x square minus of x into y, it is
dx by dy means we can write it as 1 by y dash. Then minus of yx minus y square, that is plus of 1 by it is y dash is equal to a square minus b square. That means here x square, x into y, y dash is there, and minus yx is there, and minus of y square, y dash is there. Therefore, in this place, replacing this derivative, that is y dash is equal to dy by dx by minus of dx by dy. Minus of dx by dy means that is 1 divided by y dash, we can write, and here also 1 divided by y dash we can write. Therefore, this equation, if you take LCM and then solving here, you will get back the original equation as x square by a square plus lambda plus y square divided by b square plus lambda. Then it gives the same kind of solution. Then we say that they are self-orthogonal to each other. This is called orthogonal trajectory, where you need not to solve further the differential equation for the solution. That is said to be self-orthogonal. Similarly, we consider the problems in polar form, how this polar coordinate system explains the concept of differential of orthogonal trajectory. Orthogonal trajectory in polar form. Let f of r comma theta comma alpha equal to 0 be the given family of curves. Then in this alpha is the parameter. Then you need to eliminate this alpha parameter to form a differential equation in terms of the derivative dr by d theta, and including the constants, real constants, if they appear in the equation. Okay, then alpha is the parameter that is to be eliminated. To form ODE, to form ordinary differential equation. Then, after forming a differential equation, then the DOT, that is differential of orthogonal trajectory, is given by that is dr by d theta is replaced by minus r square, that is d theta divided by it is dr. In the case of polar coordinates, that is we are taking that derivative dr by d theta, because dr by d theta, in terms of dr by d theta, we form a differential equation by eliminating the parameter which is given as alpha. Then you will get a differential equation in terms of the differential coefficient r with respect to theta. Then differential of orthogonal trajectory, we replace that dr by d theta by minus r square into d theta by dr. After solving that type of differential equation, then solving that differential equation, we get g of r comma theta comma it is beta, that is equal to 0. Then this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Therefore, equation 2 is the orthogonal trajectory to equation 1.
That means this is a family of curves in polar coordinates. This is the family of curves after applying the concept of differential of orthogonal trajectory. That means what is the meaning we discussed in Cartesian coordinates for defining the orthogonal trajectory? That is called every member of the given family of curves cut at 90 degree across to the resulting family of curves after applying the differential of orthogonal trajectory. That is the meaning of orthogonal trajectory in both the Cartesian coordinate system and as well as in polar coordinate system. Then, based on this application, we will take the problem and then how this procedure works, we will verify it. Example, find the orthogonal trajectory of r equal to a into 1 plus, it is cos theta. This is a familiar equation even in another branch of mathematics. Normally we consider this problem for polar coordinates. Wherever we come across the polar coordinates concept discussion, then we consider this problem as one of the important problem or popular problem. The name of this equation is called cardioid. Then how this cardioid takes the shape, and then after applying the orthogonal trajectory, and then what is the resulting family of curves and how it behaves orthogonal to this given curve. This is a given cardioid, and you have to eliminate your a is the parameter. A is the parameter. Then you need to eliminate this parameter a and form the differential equation in terms of dr by d theta. Let us see how this process works. Solution given, r equal to a into 1 plus cos theta. In this, you have to eliminate a. Okay. Then you have to differentiate dr by r with respect to theta to get it as dr by d theta. Otherwise, r divided by 1 plus cos theta is equal to a. Somehow you have to eliminate a through proper procedure. If one parameter is there, you are allowed to differentiate only once. That means first order differential equation you will be getting ultimately. Then differentiating with respect to theta. Differentiating with respect to theta means here this is u by v formula. Then 1 plus cos theta into dr by d theta minus numerator into minus of sin theta, that is whole divided by 1 plus cos theta whole square, that is equal to 0. This is u by v formula application. Denominator into derivative of numerator minus numerator into derivative of denominator, that is 1 plus cos theta gives us minus sin theta into d theta. I have taken here, and then denominator whole square. So denominator whole square means 1 plus cos theta whole square as it is here, that is equal to 0. I take this cross multiplication. Since denominator is not equal to 0, then 1 plus cos theta into dr by d theta minus of minus plus, that is r sine theta, that is equal to 0 into this one, where 1 plus cos theta whole square is not equal to 0. Then we are able to get this 1 plus cos theta into dr by d theta plus r sine theta equal to 0 in the absence of this parameter a. Therefore, this is called first order differential equation with respect to theta. Now, differential of orthogonal trajectory we have to apply. Replace dr by d theta by minus r square into d theta by it is dr. Replace dr by d theta by the value minus r square into d theta by dr. What is the value? Dr by d theta by minus r square d theta by dr means, as it is in the equation you write, 1 plus cos theta into minus r square, it is d theta divided by dr, plus of r sin theta, and this is equal to 0. Now what is your next step after introducing the differential of orthogonal trajectory concept? You have to solve this differential equation to get another family of curves which will be acting as orthogonal to the given curve. Then here r is common, 1 r you can cancel as a common factor, then minus of 1 plus cos theta into r, it is d theta divided by dr, and plus of sin theta equal to 0. Then you need to solve this differential equation by separating the variables, because it is easy to separate the variables here. This is d theta by dr is there, here r is also present and theta is also present. So first of all, let us separate these values. Then we will shift this r to the denominator, to the second term, and bring this sin theta here. Therefore, minus of 1 plus cos theta divided by this sin theta into d theta, and plus of, it is dr comes to numerator, divided by r equal to 0. Multiply throughout by dr and divide throughout by r into sin theta. Therefore, sin theta remains here, r remains here, and multiplying by dr means dr cancels and dr comes here. Then, what is the next step? That is, this is dr by r minus of 1 plus cos theta divided by, it is sin theta, then it is d theta equal to 0. So it is in the separated variable form. Here this is free from theta and this is free from r. Therefore, we can integrate every term to get the solution of the differential equation. You take the same step and then do that for the integration. Integrating every term, then integration of dr divided by r and plus of, that is minus of 1 plus cos theta divided by it is sin theta, and then it is d theta is equal to constant. Then, anyway, this is log r, dr by r integration is log r, and minus of 1 plus cos theta, you can write it as 2 times of cos square theta by 2, and divided by 2 times of, it is sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2, it is d theta equal to c. That means 1 plus cos theta is equal to 2 cos square theta by 2 by the formula of the trigonometric functions, and sin theta is equal to 2 times sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2. This 2 you can cancel and 1 cos you can cancel. Then log of r minus that is cos theta by 2 over, it is sin theta by 2 into d theta is equal to constant. Then what we can do here, that is cos theta by 2 divided by sin theta by 2 should be log r first term, into, that is differentiation of sin theta by 2 is cos theta by 2 into 1 divided by 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is not there here, 1 divided by 1 by 2 you have to write it. Differentiation of this sin theta by 2 is cos theta by 2 into 1 by 2.
then 1 by t is not there, then you have to take in the denominator. That is log of it is sin theta by 2 equal to constant. Then log of minus, that is minus you can avoid this, and plus sign you can write, that is 2 times it is log sin theta by 2 equal to constant. Then first term remains to be same, log r, and plus of this is 2 times of sin theta by 2, log sin theta by 2, this is whole square equal to constant. Then log of r into, that is log m plus log n, okay, sin square it is theta by 2 equal to constant. So r into sin square theta by 2 equal to e to the power c. Then what is this we are going to write? R into sin square theta by 2 becomes as, that is minus is there here, that should be plus sign, here it is minus, and here also minus and minus. Then this is 1 divided by sin square theta by 2 equal to e to the power c. Then r is equal to e to the power c into it is sin square theta by 2. Then e to the power c into sin square theta by 2 takes, that is 1 minus it is cos theta, and 1 minus cos theta divided by 2. That is in terms of the half of the angles. Once again, trigonometric ratio function, formula you are using, that is r is equal to something. Then r is equal to e to the power c divided by 2 into 1 minus cos theta. Therefore, this you can take it as 1 minus cos theta, and this you can take it as e to the power c is constant and 2 is also constant. There you can represent, that is v into 1 minus cos theta. What is our given problem? Our given problem is r equal to a into 1 plus cos theta. This represents f of r comma theta comma a equal to 0. This gives us one family of curves, which is the given problem. Now we got it as r is equal to b into 1 minus it is cos theta. This implies g of r comma theta comma b is equal to 0. So yeah, these two curves if you plot using curve tracing procedure, otherwise you can give different values of theta and you can expect the length of the radius vector. Then these two curves will intersect orthogonal to each other. That means first curve r equal to a into 1 plus cos theta, you have studied in the application of integration, the curve is symmetric with respect to the initial line as well as a pole, because initial line only, with respect to initial line only. Then the reflection you can see from the bottom, this is the cardioid, r equal to a into 1 plus cos theta. Then this is the curve we are getting, this is for r equal to a into that is b into 1 minus cos theta. So these two curves will cut or intersect at this point. This angle is 90 degree, this angle is 90 degree and this angle is 90 degree. This is 2a and this is 2b, and b equal to a, same length they take. Therefore
the given family. This is orthogonal to this, otherwise this is orthogonal to the given curve. Then this is called the initial line. X-axis always initial line, and this origin we call it as pole. Origin is called as pole. So this is at theta equal to 0, and this is at theta equal to 90 degree, and this is at theta equal to 180 degree. The curve tracing procedure explains the plot of the curve like this. Chordate in this shape, it is heart shape. For the given curve, plus sign means towards right side of the x-axis it takes the plot, but minus sign it goes towards the left side when you go on giving different values between 0 to 180 degrees. So this is one sample, and let me explain another problem on this, that is on the polar coordinates. All is equal to r square is equal to a square, which is sine 2 theta. There is another case in the same polar coordinates we discussed to write the orthogonal trajectory of the given curve. Given family of curves, the orthogonal trajectory. In the solution, we can take this one as let f of r comma theta comma a equal to 0 be the given family of curves and a is the parameter. Then, to eliminate this a, we form the differential equation 2r into dr by d theta. Directly we take the differentiation with respect to theta, that is equal to a square, then sine 2 theta, that is cos 2 theta into 2. Sine 2 theta means 2 times cos 2 theta. And then multiplying by a square. This 2 cancels. This implies a square equal to, that is r divided by, it is cos 2 theta, r divided by cos 2 theta dr by d theta. 2r into dr by d theta is equal to a square as it is. Sine 2 theta becomes 2 times of cos 2 theta after differentiation r with respect to theta. Then I try to eliminate this a square by separating the value of a square from this step, that reads a square is equal to r divided by cos 2 theta into dr by d theta. Then this equation, this is equation number 1, if you say, then 1 gives r square equal to r divided by, it is cos 2 theta, then dr by d theta, that is multiplied by, it is sine 2 theta. So in this step, a square is not there, that means parameter we eliminated to form a differential equation, ordinary differential equation. Let us try to simplify to the possible extent where r cancels here, that is r equal to sine 2 theta divided by, it is cos of 2 theta, and then it is dr by, it is d theta. Then here we replace this dr by d theta with the concept of differential of orthogonal trajectory. What is that? Dr by d theta is to be replaced by minus r square into d theta by dr. Okay. Replace dr by d theta by minus r square, it is d theta divided by dr. Then we are able to get, that is r equal to sine 2 theta divided by, it is cos 2 theta minus r square, that is d theta by dr. This is the differential equation after applying the differential of orthogonal trajectory. Then now you have to solve this differential equation to get another family of curves in terms of some other constant, otherwise it is called parameter. Then you can explain that, or you can plot that curve which will be the orthogonal trajectory to the given curve. Then once again this R you can cancel on both sides, so one R you can cancel. Then that is dr divided by R. If you take this R cross multiplication and R cross multiplication here, then this is equal to minus of, it is sine 2 theta divided by cos 2 theta into d theta. It is called separated variable form. Then integrating every term, you have to solve this. Integrating, we get log r equal to minus of, that is integration of cos 2 theta, sine 2 theta by cos 2 theta gives us, that is integration on both sides you are applying, and plus constant. That means cos 2 theta differentiation is sine 2 theta with a minus, and 2 is not there but minus is there already, so that you can take it as 1 by 2. 2 is not there, 1 by 2. Then what you have to take, that is minus is there already, and log of cos of, it is 2 theta plus constant. Then remaining is simplification. That is log r is equal to minus 1 by 2 is there, log of cos of 2 theta, what to the power minus 1 by 2 plus constant. That is log of r divided by cos 2 theta to the power minus 1 by 2 and equal to c. That is r divided by cos 2 theta whole to the power minus 1 by 2 equal to b to the power c. That is equal to something like you can write b or b square, because a square is given, we will take it as b square for some convenience in the final step. Then what is this r? That is equal to cos 2 theta, that is denominator, actually left side that becomes as denominator as is, minus log r log cos 2 theta and all that. Okay, then r is equal to cos 2 theta 4 to the power minus half into b square. Then r is equal to cos 2 theta means 2 cos 2a is equal to 2 cos square a minus 1. That is 2 cos square theta, 2 cos square theta minus 1, then into b square whole to the power minus half. Then this can be taken as the resulting equation, which will be the orthogonal trajectory to the given equation. R square is equal to a square sine 2 theta. So this is orthogonal to the given curve. Then we say that concept of orthogonal trajectory in the case of polar coordinates also holds good to give the given family of family of curves will be intersecting to the resulting family of curves at 90 degrees. This is the concept of orthogonal trajectory. Now we shall discuss the next application on differential equation. That is, as per the two topics mentioned in the syllabus, that is, one is total three applications are there. One is orthogonal trajectory, next one is Newton's law of cooling, and one more is RL circuits. Okay, next we shall discuss on Newton's law of cooling. Second application, that is Newton's law of cooling. Here, in the Newton's law of cooling, we consider the system where initially with some temperature the body is heated and after a certain time it becomes cooling. So, before initial timings and final timings, what will be the variation of the temperature at the initial time to the final time? So, this type of system will be defined in the form of ordinary differential equation. We consider this as Newton's law of cooling. So, the introduction goes like this for this Newton's law of cooling: as the temperature of the body changes at a rate which is proportional to the difference between that of surrounding medium and that of the body itself. The temperature of the body changes at a rate which is proportional to the difference between that of surrounding medium and that of the body itself. Then, if theta naught is the temperature of the surrounding and theta be the temperature of the body, at any time t, then we define d theta divided by dt, that is equal to minus k into theta minus theta naught, where k is the constant. That means change in the temperature with respect to time is equal to minus k, that is theta minus theta naught. This is temperature at any time and this is temperature at the initial or the surrounding in the beginning. Then the differential equation explains d theta by dt is equal to minus k into theta minus theta naught, and minus sign is chosen here because temperature flows from higher level towards the lower level. Then this is the governing differential equation even in the application of Newton's law of cooling for various bodies. That means this is a general case, but at the specific case study also, this is the same term which theta changes and corresponding t changes will be written as d theta by dt. And theta minus theta naught means this is the unknown value and this is the given value. And k we have to calculate. What is the value of k for the given data? So, based on this, we will have to solve the differential equation with the given type of data. So, now I shall take one example on this, how this differential equation works in this particular type of explanation it is given. The temperature of the body changes at a rate which is proportional to the difference between that of the surrounding medium and that of the body itself. Let me give an example, the problem, how this differential equation can be framed and then how this differential equation can be solved. Example is like this: a body originally at
80 degrees centigrade cools down to 60 degrees centigrade in 20 minutes. 20 minutes, the temperature of the air, the temperature of the air being 40 degree centigrade, then what is the, or what will be the temperature of the body after 40 minutes from the original? This is the statement of the problem, and the variation in the temperature it is given, and variation in the time it is also given. You have to apply the equation, that is d theta by dt is equal to minus k into theta minus theta naught. How it works, in order to calculate the required time and also the required temperature change.
Okay, in the solution, first you record the data as it is. If theta be the temperature at time t, then theta equal to 40 degrees centigrade, theta equal to 40 degrees centigrade will be, it is given 40 degrees centigrade, that is surrounding means that becomes A, will be the temperature of the air. Then ODB is given by
the same differential equation just now we have defined, that can be written as d theta divided by dt is equal to minus k into theta minus it is 40.
Then this is the differential equation, and you solve for theta from this differential equation by separating the variables like this. That is d theta divided by, you take this term to the left side denominator, equal to minus k into it is dt. Then integrating on both sides.
First you calculate the value of theta, afterwards the given data will be introduced, initially at what degree, from what degree to what degree it cools down, and then what will be the time taken. So that is what the calculation we are doing.
Now after integration of this, that is d theta divided by theta minus 40, you can write it as d theta divided by theta minus 40 is equal to minus k into dt, and plus of c you can write. Therefore, that is log of, it is theta minus 40, because differentiation of theta minus 40 is d theta, then log of that denominator we can write, minus k into t plus, it is constant, k into dt integration is t, and that is plus of constant. Then theta minus 40 is equal to e to the power minus kt plus of constant e to the power c into e to the power minus of kt you can write. Then if this is the value, that you can write it as a, some other constant, e to the power c into e to the power minus of it is kt. Therefore, theta minus 40 is equal to a into e to the power minus of it is kT. So this is the equation we are getting. Now at t is equal to 0 initial time and theta is equal to, it is 80 degree given in the problem. Now you write that one, theta is equal to 0, t equal to 0, theta is equal to 80. You substitute that here, that is theta equal to 80, 80 minus 40 is equal to a into e to the power minus k into, it is 0. Then a is equal to, that is 40. So a is equal to 40, you substitute here in this equation, that is theta minus 40 is equal to 40 into e to the power minus of kt. Now use the second set of values, it is given in the problem. At t is equal to 20, at t is equal to 20 and theta is equal to, cools down from 80 to 60 degree centigrade. Then theta minus 40 equal to, that is in place of theta you can substitute as 60, that is equal to 40 and e to the power minus of k into, that is 20. K into, that is 20. So what is the answer you have to write? That is k into 20. So this becomes 20 equal to 40 e to the power minus of 20, it is k. Then this becomes 1 by 20 equal to e to the power, that is minus of 20 k. Minus of 20 k. Then, so e to the power minus 20 k, and then you can write the value of k. You have to take this one, value of k. You have to write it as log, that is 20. So log 1 divided by 20 equal to log of e to the power something is minus of 20, that is k. Then k takes the value of minus 1 by 20 log of 1 by 20. Therefore theta minus 40, theta minus 40 is equal to 40 into e to the power, that is minus k. So e to the power minus k, k is equal to this one, that is 1 divided by 20 into log of 1 by 20, that is multiplied by t, is the solution. That means theta in terms of t. Theta was a function of t, therefore theta is a function of t. We have calculated as a solution of that differential equation. So now we will use that. The last required data, last required calculation for the last required data, that is at t is equal to 40, what is the temperature? At t is equal to 40 minutes, theta equal to, what is the temperature? Therefore, theta minus 40 is equal to 40 e to the power 1 by 20 and log of 1 by 20 into, that is 40. Then this calculation gives, that is theta is equal to 50 degree centigrade. Therefore, when you substitute that value for getting the temperature value at that time, that is t is equal to 40 minutes, then what will be the temperature? Means temperature becomes, that is 50 degree centigrade. So this is how the Newton's law of cooling works for the given type of variation of temperature with respect to the variation of time which is given in the problem. Then another application, there are three applications in this. RL circuit There is a third application in this RL circuit, that means R means resistance and L means that is inductance of the circuit, that is called RL circuit. Here we use the concept of Kirchhoff laws. What is that Kirchhoff law? We'll have to define it. In a series circuit containing only a resistor and an inductor, Kirchhoff's second law states that the sum of the voltage, the sum of the voltage drop across the resistor, across the inductor, that is L into D I divided by dt, and the voltage drop across the resistor, that is I into capital R, is same as the impressed voltage, capital E of T on the circuit. Then ODE for this is given by L into DI by DT plus R into I equal to E to the power T in the circuit. This is a differential equation. In a series circuit containing only a resistance you can write it as R, and an inductor, that you can write it as capital L. Kirchhoff's second law states that the sum of the voltage drop across the inductor, that is L into DI by DT, and the voltage drop across the resistor, that is I into R, is same as the impressed voltage Vt on the circuit. Then the governing differential equation is given by L into DI by DT plus R into I. R into I is equal to impressed voltage. So this is what the second law which is defined by Kirchhoff. Then based on this, the values of the L, value of R, value of L and value of E, if which values are given, let us see how this differential equation can be solved by the application of the given data. Now we will solve this differential equation with the analytical method. That analytical method of solving the differential equation is nothing but this is I is a function of t, I is a current, t is a time, here also I is there and here t is there. Exactly this differential equation takes the application of linear differential equation procedure. Then how this linear differential equation can be solved, already we have discussed in the previous one of the lectures how this linear differential equation gives the calculation of the integrating factor, and then what is the solution of that integrating factor we will have to verify, and then how this integrating factor works for the solution of the differential equation. Now, presently this differential equation, we can define it as, which is a linear differential equation. Linear differential equation is linear in y, that means pi power as 1, therefore I degree as 1, therefore it is called, first degree means it is called linear differential equation. So linear differential equation means we have to solve by calculating the integrating factor. We will find out the integrating factor for this linear differential equation. Consider the same differential equation in another form, where we remove the coefficients in the first term, coefficients in the first term, and rewrite in the second term coefficient. Okay, then solution. What is the solution of this? Let di divided by dt plus of r by l into I is equal to 1 divided by l, it is e to the power t. This differential equation exactly resembles the meaning of linear differential equation. How? This is dy by dx plus p of x dy by dx plus p of x into y equal to q of x is that. This is your linear differential equation in the standard form. Here y equal to I you can take, and x equal to p you can take, and et this one you can take it as q of x, together that 1 by l, anyway it is a constant. Then so p of x into y, so p of x is not a function of x, this value existing, but this is a function of x. P of x is a constant in the existing equation. That is, P of x is equal to r divided by l. R divided by l, the value of P of x. Then we need to write this as P of x. Then integrating factor. Is, what is the integrating factor for this? IF equal to e to the power integral p of x into dx. E to the power integral p of x into dx. Right, exactly according to that. That is IF equal to e to the power integral r by l. R by L into, that is dt, because x equal to p, therefore e to the power r by L into p will be the integrating factor. Then solution is given by, what is the solution of this? After finding the integrating factor, you have studied in the linear differential equation chapter, the solution is given by dependent variable into integrating factor is equal to integration, that is q of x, integration q of x into IF, that is integrating factor, that is dx, and plus of constant. That is the solution step. If this is the standard form, then integrating factor is this term, and the solution is y into integrating factor, that is dependent variable, and equal to right side p of x into integrating factor, that is dx plus constant. So this part we will write like this. Here the dependent variable is I into e to the power r by l into t is equal to integration, that is 1 by L into e to the power the function of t into e to the power r by L into t, that
that is dt plus constant. This is the general solution
before introducing the actual values of R, L and E. This is the solution method.
For the linear differential equation, when once we define RL circuit, then the linear differential equation can be solved by finding the integrating factor like this. Then dependent variable into integrating factor is equal to integration of right side function into integrating factor, and that is with respect to t plus constant.
So this is the solution step where we take or where we consider the solution procedure after finding the integrating factor in this way. In my next lecture, I will solve the problem how this equation can be solved by finding the integrating factor with the given values of L, R and E value, if it is given like that.
Okay.
Then how to find out the integrating factor and how to write a final step and how to interpret the results for the application of RL circuit.